Hello, I'm Victor Carl Chan, and I'm a PhD candidate at the University of Toronto. I work in the field of cosmology, which focuses on the study of the larger scales of the universe. The furthest thing that we can see with the naked eye is the Andromeda Galaxy, which is located 2.5 million light years away. We can do a lot better than our eyes with instruments like space telescopes. The JWST, for example, has observed a galaxy which formed 300 million years after the Big Bang. This means that its light has been traveling toward us for over 13 billion years. The JWST will continue to observe new objects that will probably be even farther away than this. But the furthest light that we will ever be able to see is the cosmic microwave background, or CMB. This is the residual light from the hot Big Bang. In the very early universe, everything was very dense, which meant that it was opaque and we couldn't see through it. As the universe evolved, things moved farther and farther away from each other. The universe eventually transitioned to becoming transparent. We call this transition point from when the universe was opaque to becoming transparent, the surface of last scattering. We can think of this transition as the universe starting out as a hot, dense soup that gradually gets diluted until it's clear enough that light can pass through it. When we look out into the universe, we actually see the reverse. We're currently living in a transparent universe, but when we look far enough away, we eventually see a point at which the universe becomes opaque. We actually do think that the universe is infinite and stretches on forever. But we also know that it has a finite age because it started with the Big Bang. So since the speed of light is finite, and we only had so much time for the light to travel, we can only see so far back in time. This is also coupled with the fact that the surface of last scattering exists. And like I said before, once we try to look far enough back away in time, eventually the universe becomes completely opaque and we can't see farther past it. This means that we'll never be able to see the entire universe. We would think that, for the most part, things would look pretty similar. The cosmological principle is an idea that we share that, for the most part, the universe looks the same in all directions and no matter where you are. So if we could move out to a distant galaxy and look out into the universe, we might be able to observe different objects, but the kinds of objects that we would observe and the amount of them should be pretty similar to what we can observe here. And similarly, if we were to look out as far away as we could, we would also see a surface of last scattering, although it wouldn't be exactly the same surface of last scattering as the one we see here. It's a little intimidating to think that there are objects out there in the universe that we'll never be able to observe. We think that the things that we can observe from Earth are pretty representative of the universe as a whole. So we don't think that it's a problem because we should have all the information that we'll ever need, and we just have to figure out how to use it properly.